Hello. No doubt you've heard about ChatGPT and many other similar language model chatbots. Its usefulness in numerous industries, especially research-based ones, is difficult to understate. But how does it help, if it does at all, web scraping? To start, it's crucial to understand that ChatGPT is far from perfect, as I'm sure many of you who have used it already know. Excluding its hallucinations, ChatGPT has an information cutoff point of 2021. Unsurprisingly, this is a major limitation of this language model, as industries like data gathering tend to evolve and change quite drastically, in order to avoid being countered by anti-web scraping efforts. But does that make ChatGPT useless for web scraping? The short answer is no. Before moving to the step-by-step guide, let's briefly introduce our demo target for this tutorial. We will extract data from the Oxylabs sandbox, a dummy e-commerce store that maintains video game listings in several categories. Here's what the landing page of the store looks like. Also, if you've used Oxylabs Sandbox in your own testing environment, let us know in the comments below what you liked about it. Now, let's delve into the steps required to scrape data from this webpage using ChatGPT. The first step is creating a ChatGPT account. Visit ChatGPT's login page and hit sign up. You also have the option to sign up using your Google account. On successful signup, you will be redirected to the chat window. You can initiate a chat by entering your query in the text field. The second step is locating the elements to scrape, so before prompting ChatGPT, let's first locate the elements we need to extract from the target page. Assume that we need only the video game titles and prices. Begin by right-clicking one of the game titles and selecting Inspect. This will open the HTML code for this element in the Developer Tools window. Then, right-click the element and select Copy Selector with the game title in it. The following figure explains it all. Afterwards, write down the selector and repeat the same to find the selector for the price element. The third step is to prepare the ChatGPT prompt. The prompt should be well explained, specifying the code's programming language, tools and libraries to be used, element selectors, output, and any special instructions the code must comply with. Here's a sample prompt that you can use to create the web scraper using Python and Beautiful Soup. Notice we have provided CSS selectors for price and titles that we copied in the earlier step. Also, the scraped data might contain a few odd characters if not handled properly due to encoding issues. It happens when the web page and the Python script interpret the character encoding differently. Therefore, we can add relevant additional instructions to avoid these encoding issues. The fourth step is to review the code. Once ChatGPT replies with a code, it's always a good idea to review it first. Just overview the code if it seems to do what you want it to do. Double-check if it uses some libraries or packages you may wish to exclude. If you find any inherent glitches, write back to ChatGPT and ask to generate the code again. Lastly, the fifth step is to execute and test. Copy the ChatGPT generated code and check if it's executing fine. Here's the code that ChatGPT generated for us. Also, remember to install the Beautiful Soup library and Requests library before running the code. This can be done by opening the terminal and running this. Here's the snippet of the output CSV file generated after executing the code. Congratulations, you just effortlessly scraped the target website. But what if the code executes in some exceptions or the output is not as you desired? Well, there are certain tips and tricks that you can follow to get the most accurate and desired information from ChatGPT. Begin with getting code editing assistance. ChatGPT provides one of the remarkable features of code editing. If the generated code doesn't meet your requirements or generates some wrong output, you can ask to edit the code based on your needs. You should also specify the changes you want to make, such as modifying the scraped elements, boosting the effectiveness of the code, or modifying the data extraction procedure. ChatGPT can offer you additional code options or modify suggestions to improve the web scraping process. Another tip is linting codes for quality. Linting codes increase their readability and maintainability. ChatGPT can assist you with code linting by recommending best practices, spotting potential syntax problems, and enhancing code readability. To adhere to coding standards and practices, you can ask ChatGPT to review the code and provide recommendations. You can even paste your code and ask ChatGPT to lint it. You can do so by adding the "lint the code" phrase in the additional instructions of the prompt. Also, when it comes to web scraping, efficiency is critical, especially when working with large datasets or challenging web scraping tasks. ChatGPT can provide tips on how to increase the performance of your code. For example, you can ask for advice on how to use frameworks and packages that speed up web scraping, use caching techniques, exploit concurrency or parallel processing, and minimize pointless network calls. Another important aspect of ChatGPT is that it can help handle dynamic content. Certain websites produce dynamic content using JavaScript libraries or use AJAX requests to produce the content. ChatGPT can help you navigate such complex web content. You can acquire ChatGPT for the techniques to get the dynamic content from such JavaScript render pages. ChatGPT can offer suggestions on using headless browsers, parsing dynamic HTML, or even automating interactions using simulated user actions. So, we've now discussed how you can use ChatGPT to assist you in a web scraping task and looked at the steps of doing so. However, we haven't really discussed the limitations of ChatGPT in web scraping. Notably, large language models such as GPT-3, which powers ChatGPT, are fundamentally prone to the hallucination problem. This means ChatGPT can return responses that are factually incorrect or inconsistent with reality. Understanding the limitations of ChatGPT is therefore crucial. Although it has been trained extensively on a massive amount of data, there are instances where it may produce code snippets unsuitable for direct execution. Therefore, reviewing and verifying the ChatGPT response and the resulting code before executing is imperative. There are also some other limitations of using ChatGPT for web scraping. Many websites have implemented strong security measures to block automated scrapers from accessing the sites. Commonly, sites use CAPTCHAs and request rate limiting to prevent automated scraping. Therefore, simple ChatGPT-generated scrapers may fail at these sites. So, while ChatGPT has made writing simple web scrapers a trivial task, anything that goes beyond that may find rather limited success. Thanks for watching, like and subscribe, and we hope to see you again next time.